شرکت تجارتی بارک در بیلشتراسه 137 شهر هامبورگ جهت سهولت هموطنان عزیز دو قلم عمده جاروب برقی بارک با قدرت خیلی قوی را با اسمارت باکس شما می توانید تمام کانال های افغانی، ایندی و ورزشی را مشاهده کنید با قیمت های کاملا مناسب در دسترس شما گذاشته است. برنج درجه یک دانه بلند بارک با کیفیت اعلی را می توانید از شرکت بارک به دست دارید. همچنان در فروشگاه تجارتی بارک شما بهترین و متنوع ترین اشیای الکترونیکی را با مارک های مختلف از سراسر جهان به طور پرچون و عمده دریافت می توانید. شرکت تجارتی بارک بیلشتراسه 137 شهر هامبورگ به مدیریت آقای نصیر بارکزی.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. حياكم الله وبياكم. إن الحمد لله أحمده تعالى وأستعين به وأستغفره وأستهديه، وأعوذ بالله العلي العظيم من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا وعظيمنا وحبيبنا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. Dear respective brothers and sisters in Islam, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. Again today, inshallah, in this blessed Friday, we are talking about the superiority of the month of Sha'ban, where we are now, and what Muslims should do in this month. Aisha radiallahu anha, our mother, the mother of the believers, أم المؤمنين, said, لم يكن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يصوم شهرا أكثر من شعبان فإنه كان يصومه كله إلا قليل. She said, Aisha radiallahu anha, may Allah be pleased with her, رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, mostly he used to fast the whole month of Sha'ban except a few days of it. The scholar, they said maybe he used to fast 27 or 28 days, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, dear brothers, dear sisters, he used to fast the most of the month of Sha'ban? Our hadith, narrated by Al-Imam Al-Nasa'i and Sheikh Al-Albani, said it is authentic hadith. Usama ibn Zayd قال قلت يا رسول الله لم أرك تصوم شهرا من الشهور ما تصوم من شعبان قال ذلك شهر يغفل عنه الناس بين رجب ورمضان وهو شهر ترفع فيه الأعمال إلى رب العالمين. The meaning of this hadith, Usama ibn Zayd, he asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, saying, Ya Rasulullah, mostly you used to fast the among the Hijri calendar month, mostly, طبعاً except of the month of Ramadan, you are fasting the most of the month of Sha'ban. Why, Ya Rasulullah? Why you're fasting a lot of days during this month? Actually, most of the month. Why, Ya Rasulullah? Usama ibn Zayd asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ذَلِكَ شَهْرٌ يَغْفُلُ عَنْهُ النَّاسِ. Because most of Muslims or people, they are heedless of the month of Sha'ban, because the month of Sha'ban comes by Rajab Mudar, and Rajab, it is a sacred month. And Ramadan, it's a month of Ramadan. And subhanAllah, Sha'ban, it is not a holy month or a sacred month, but that month has certain superiority. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is receiving all of our deeds in the month of Sha'ban. That's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I would like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to receive my deeds while I am fasting. This is what he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And second reason, because the time of Sha'ban is a time of ghafla, heedlessness. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam described it as a time of ghafla, heedlessness. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that. But let's see the first reason, because that month is the month of heedlessness. People, they are heedless about it, of it. And how Islam talks about those who are remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, al-mufridun, those who are remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala while others, they are heedless. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, سَبَقَ الْمُفْرِدُونَ. The mufridun, those who are worshipping Allah while others not, they are the foremost people. The foremost people, وَالسَّابِقُونَ السَّابِقُونَ. سَبَقَ الْمُفْرِدُونَ, he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he said, وَالذَّاكَرِينَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا وَالذَّاكِرَاتِ. Those from among men, those who are remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala much. وَالذَّاكِرَاتِ, from among women too, the believing men and the believing women. الْمُعْتَزِلُونَ النَّاسِ, those who are away from people. They are worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during the time of ghafla. This is what he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم, the most or the nearest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at night while you are praying tahajjud, making qiyam layl, tahajjud, praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, especially at night, in the last third of every night, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that. These people, they are very near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, while others are sleeping, heedless of the qiyam al-layl, the dhikr Allah, tahajjud, any act of worshipping, people are heedless. You are standing at night. You are different from everybody. You are worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why Rasulullah used to fast that month, because one of the reasons, people are heedless of it. Also because sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, look at this beautiful hadith. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, al-ibadatu fil harji كهجرة إلي. العبادة في الهرج كهجرة إلي. Worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during the time of harj. What is harj means? Harj means killing. Harj means fitna, temptations. Harj means attraction, fitna, problems, calamities, plagues, sickness, poverty. Huh? To worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala while all others are busy, what during the time of that fitna, ikhtilat, and the umur, wal fitna, you don't know what's right, what's wrong. When you worship Allah during that time, as if you migrated to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Kahijratin ilay. Imagine Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam at al-Madinah al-Munawwara. You are coming from Afghanistan, from Egypt, from Middle East, from India, from Pakistan, from Iran, from any country. You're going to Allah subhanahu, to Rasulullah. You're going to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You are immigrating to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you worship Allah during the time of fitna, al-harj, now, like now, subhanallah, you will worship Allah as if you migrated to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Al-Imam al-Nawawi said that. And the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling us also, while others are busy, when you worship Allah like the month of Sha'ban. So everybody nowadays, they're talking about coronavirus. All social media, 99.9, they are talk people, of the people around the world, they are talking about coronavirus. This is the top in the media now. I'm asking Allah Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala to save all humanity from coronavirus, from any kind of sickness. I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save and survive our beautiful country, United States of America. May Allah save all the humanity, all American. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save them. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stop that coronavirus and stop any kind of illness for this beautiful people here in this beautiful country. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. May Allah save all the humanity from any kind of illness and sickness ya Rabbal Alameen. An-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when you enter the market and you say this dua, because, why the market ya Rasulullah? Because the market is that everybody's busy, everybody's in ghafla, everybody's busy with selling, buying, taking, giving, you know, people busy in the market. What they are doing in the market, you know what people are doing in the market. Their mission is to make money or to get something. They never, 99% of them, they are not remembering Allah during that time, because this time of business. And the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, let me say the hadith. He said, if you enter the souq, and if you say, La ilaha illallah, this dua, when you enter the souq, the market, look how much reward you will get, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. When you enter the market, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if you say, La ilaha illallah, remember that hadith, don't forget it. The dua, when you enter the market, every day you are going to the market. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ya Rabbil Alameen, inshallah, give us safety again, inshallah, to return back to our masajid, to return back to our markets, inshallah, to return back, to go back again to our normal life, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. He said that dua, when you enter the market, if you say it, La ilaha illallah, وحده لا شريك له, له الملك وله الحمد, يحيي ويميت, وهو حي لا يموت, بيده الخير, وهو على كل شيء قدير. If you say this dua, this kind of dua, huh? When you enter the market, to say لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. This is توحيد. له الملك وله الحمد. الملك and the الحمد belong to him. يحيي ويميت. He is the one who causing people to life and death. وهو حي. He is ever living. سبحانه وتعالى. He never die. And he will never die. سبحانه وتعالى. لا يموت. Huh? بيده الخير. All خيرات in his hand. الله سبحانه وتعالى. That's why you have to make دعاء in this month, to ask Allah for khairat, for the good of dunya and the akhirah. وهو على كل شيء قدير, he's capable, almighty, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you do that, if you say that when you enter the market, كتب له ألف ألف حسنة. ألف ألف means thousand, thousand means 1,000,000. Sahaba, they never heard and they did not know about a million, this word. But the million for them, they used to say ألف ألف, thousand, thousand. فألف ألف حسنة, 1,000,000 حسنة, they're gonna get it. ومحى عنه ألف ألف سيئة, 1,000,000 sin will be wiped out. Oh, الله أكبر. ورفع له ألف ألف درجة. And he will, Allah will elevate him in Jannah, 1,000,000 steps. 1,000,000 steps in Jannah, درجة. Allah will elevate him. That hadith authentic, narrated by Imam al-Tirmizi. Why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam talk about the market? Because the market, it is a place of ghafla, heedlessness. وفي الحديث that narrated by Imam Ahmad, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if somebody traveling with a group of people while they are sleeping at night, he stood up and prayed tahajjud, then he wake them up to travel in the morning, that man, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, will forgive him, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will look at him because he remembered Allah while others are sleeping. Number two, why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to fast mostly of the month of Sha'ban. First of all, shahrun turfa'u fihi al-a'mal. That month, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is receiving the deeds of his creatures. Not, is that only that in the month of Sha'ban? No. Every day, your deeds, dear brothers and sisters, are showing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Salat al-Asr and the Salat al-Fajr. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Rabbil Alameen, allow us to go back to the Masjid of Allah, to open the Kaaba again, to open the Masjid al-Nabawi in Medina al-Munawwara again, the Masjid al-Haram again. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Rabbil Alameen, take this harm away from the humanity and allow us to worship you, Ya Rabbil Alameen, to worship you, Ya Rabbil Alameen, in our masajid again, Ya Arhamar Rahimeen, Ya Rabbil Alameen. Dear brothers, your deeds are showing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala every day in Salat al-Asr and Salat al-Fajr. Your deeds are showing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala every week, every Thursday night, means the night of Friday, the end of the Thursday, يعني Salat al-Thursday evening, the night of Friday, your deeds are showing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also the whole entire deeds during the year, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala receive it from the malaika, every year in the month of Sha'ban. يعني your Ramadan, Taraweeh last year, Allah will receive it this month. And subhanallah, He will give you another extra hasanat in the month of Ramadan, the coming Ramadan, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. That's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah is not heedless, Allah is not ghafil, Allah knows, He's aware about what we are doing. That's why try to do your best, dear brothers, dear sisters. Also, in the month of Sha'ban, the night of 15th of the month of Sha'ban, or the 15th night of Sha'ban, look what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. Qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, يَطَّلِعُ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ عَلَى خَلْقِهِ لَيْلَةَ النِّصْفِ مِنْ شَعْبَانِ فَيَغْفِرُ لِجَمِيعِ خَلْقِهِ إِلَّا الْمُشْرِكُ وَالْمُشَاحِنِ. أخرجه البيهقي وصححه الشيخ الألباني في الترغيب والترهيب. وقال في حديث آخر, يطلع الله على عباده ليلة النصف من شعبان فيغفر للمؤمنين ويمهل الكافرين ويدع أهل الحقد بحقدهم حتى يدعوه. سبحان الله. These two hadiths talking about the 15th night of the month of Sha'ban, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is looking in that night from Salat al-Maghrib to Salat al-Fajr. Every night Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is descending on our heaven the last third of every night. But the night of 15th of Sha'ban, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the beginning of the night, يعني Salat al-Maghrib to Salat al-Fajr, Allah is descending to our heaven. And He's looking at us, Almighty Azza wa Jal. And He is looking at us, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Bismillah. Okay. And He is forgiving all of His creature, during that night, from Maghrib to Salat al-Fajr. Inshallah, that night, brothers, this coming Tuesday, gonna be the night, of Wednesday. That will be the night of 15th of Sha'ban. I'm gonna tell you what you're gonna do. Okay, to do the sunnah, inshallah. First of all, Allah will look at His creatures and He will forgive them, except the kafir, the mushrik, and He will forgive the mu'mineen and those who have hatred in their hearts. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, forget about them until they come back to each others. And the hatred means animosity, envy, all kind of illness of the hearts in their hearts, full of hatred, their hearts. Subhanallah, these people, they will not be forgiven. That's why before that day, if you're not talking to somebody, go talk to him. Yes, for the sake of Allah, say assalamu alaikum. I'm just saying salam to you. Why? Because I want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive me. Before that night, say ya Rabb, I don't have any hatred against anybody. Declare it, say it with your tongue. Ya Rab, forgive me. Ya Rab, anybody talks about me or did anything against me, I forgive him for your sake. Ya Rab, why? Because I want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive me. Wallahi ya jama'ah, it's a big deal. It's a big deal with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One night you will be forgiven and Allah is offering you without nothing just because you are mu'min, you are Muslim. What is this? Ramadan, it's coming, Ramadan is extra. Something extra for you. That's why Jannah is not free. You do that, inshallah, you will be rewarded. You will get a lot of reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Dear brothers and dear sisters, we have to learn something from this hadith. Some people, they are doing innovations the night of 15th of Sha'ban. I am not asking you to do any ragaib or any innovation or anything. Try to do one thing. Stuck with it. This is what the scholar said. أكثر الإمام الشافعي said that. أكثروا فيه من الدعاء. Try to make دعاء as much as you can. والله, I swear, we are in need to this دعاء. Nowadays, people are suffering. They are frightened. They are in fear from sickness, from poverty, no jobs, too many things, from death. People, they are sitting home. Some people, they get tired already. They are crying already because they are just sitting. They lose their business. They lose everything. Why? Allah wants us from something, one thing from us. Again, I mention it in the end, inshallah. After 5 minutes, again, I tell you, what is this? What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted from us to take this corona or this sickness or this poverty away from us? Again, I tell you the secret. From the Quran, read verse number 42-43 in Surah Al-An'am, the chapter of the cattle. Surah Al-An'am, 50,000 angels, they came with Jibreel to give this surah one shot to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The chapter of the cattle. At night, all the chapter, great chapter. Jibreel is not enough. Yeah, with 70,000 angels, they are carrying that gift to Rasulullah and to us. Verse number 42 and 43. Again, I mention it to you right now. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted from us, to take this corona away. Wallahi, believe me, I have no doubt about the Quran. Now, Imam Shafi'i said, Allah wasi' al-maghfira. Allah rahim. Allah wadud. Allah kareem. He's all merciful, all generous. Just beg him, humble yourself to Allah, ask for forgiveness, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you. The night of 15th of Sha'ban, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted us to make dua. Al-dua mustajab, Imam Shafi'i said, akthiru fiha min al-dua. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ghafoor, rahim. Whatever you did, you ask for forgiveness, wallahi, I swear, he will forgive you. According to the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. إن الشيطان قال وعزتك يا رب لا أبرح أغوي عبادك ما دامت أرواحهم في أجسادهم. Shaitan said, I will misguide your servants of Allah if their ruh is still in their bodies. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, by my عزة, I swear by my dignity, my جلال, my جمال, لا أزال أغفر لهم ما استغفروني. The hadith narrated by Imam Ahmad, authentic hadith. والله, Allah sweared by his عزة and جلال and جمال, I will continue forgiving them when they ask for forgiveness. Allahu Akbar. Whenever you make sin, just say, Astaghfirullah wa atubu ilayh. This is what Allah wants us to do. Wallahi, make general tawbah, istighfar, humbleness to Allah, some tears. He will take this corona away. What is corona? Can you see corona with your eyes? Weak, invisible, nothing. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ سُوءًا أو يظلم نفسه ثم يستغفر الله يجد الله غفورا رحيما. Whosoever make any sin or sow or evil acts and he oppress, he was unjust to himself. ثم للتراخي. He said ثم and then, even after 80 years. Said ثم للتراخي. يعني even after 80 years. After you became 19, you became 100 years. You make all of these years sin. Allah said ثم. Allah, look to the Quran. He's opening still the door of tawbah for you. ثم يستغفر الله. مضارع, present. Ask Allah for forgiveness. You will find Allah is all forgiving, all merciful. Allahu Akbar. Brothers, those who are sitting partner with Allah, they have no chance, no part, no portion of forgiveness. Worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And those who are having hatred. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, فساد ذات البين هي الحلقة. Fasad that al-bayn, that problems and the animosity between Muslims, it is al-haliqa, the shavior. I'm not saying to shave your hair. No, it's shaving your deen, making thumla, a hole in your Islam. Dear brothers, dear sisters, really, think about that. Laylat al-Nisf min Sha'ban, the 15th of Sha'ban night, it is not Laylat al-Qadr. ليلة القدر الله سند قرآن إنت إن أنزلناه في ليلة المباركة ليلة القدر إن أنزلناه في ليلة القدر but as I told you it is not but what you have to do in the ليلة النصف من شعبان that night دعاء as much as you can. نعم. About fasting, if you are not fasting all شعبان, don't fast in the last 15 days. If you are fasting all شعبان, you can fast Monday, Thursday. يعني don't make yourself tired before Ramadan, especially last 2 weeks of fasting. You can fast Monday, Thursdays, okay. But don't fast too much because be ready for Ramadan, inshallah, رب العالمين. Dear brothers, dear sisters, what we have to say now, corona, virus corona. In these 5 minutes, let me talk about virus corona. People again, يعني subhanAllah, they are suffering still. They are in fear still. I want you in that night, please, make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to open his masajid, to take this corona away. Make dua for your country, for your society, for all humanity. We are human, we are brothers and sisters in humanity, insaniya. And subhanallah, we have to love each other, we have to come now to each other. I wish if the all war around the world is gonna stop and just focus about that. Humble yourself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And follow the instructions of the people of the authority, please. Don't go to the masajid now. Wait until they allow you. And please, don't go to big gathering. Brothers, clean yourself. Put the mask. Stay home as much as you can if you don't have anything important. Follow the instructions of the people of the authority, because really they work for you. And I'm giving my thanks to all doctors. They are really the big soldiers nowadays. In America, United States, all medical doctors, all those who are in the hospitals, the nurses and the staff of subhanallah medical, whatever in that field, I'm giving special thanks and dua for them, because they are like a war now for them. They are sacrificing their life for you, for your safety. Be responsible, brothers and sisters. Stay home. Those who are listening to me in Afghanistan, in Iran, in Egypt, in America, in the United States, in Germany, all over the world, please try to follow the system, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. Make dua. And this time also help everybody. Make charity and serve your community. Please somehow do that, inshallah. I promise you, I will finish my khutbah today, how to solve the problem of corona. And this is a call for everybody around the world. Look at the verse number 42-43 in Surah Al-An'am. Allah said, وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا إِلَىٰ أُمَمٍ مِّن قَبْلِكَ فَأَخَذْنَاهُمْ بِالْبَأْسَاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ لَعَلَّهُمْ ده اللي احنا لازم نعمله. يتضرعون فلولا إذ جاءهم بأسنا تضرعوا ولكن قست قلوبهم وزين لهم الشيطان ما كانوا يعملون. The meaning of these two ayahs and the solution is here. To get out of your poverty, to get out of your sickness, illness, to get out of corona, to get out of any problems in your life. Look what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. We have sent messengers to many nations before you, O Muhammad, calling for the right path to Allah, to worship Allah alone. But because of their arrogance, they rejected them. They rejected the messengers because of their arrogance. As such, we seized them with the extreme poverty, al-ba'sa in Arabic. Wad-darra, loss of health, sickness, and many calamities, hoping that they might return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with humility and believe in his oneness. Brothers and sisters, we need to sit in their knees with humbleness to God, ask for forgiveness. Wallahi, make dua. Ask for forgiveness as much as you can. Allah will take all of these calamities away from you. And Allah said, فَلَوْلَا إِذْ جَاءُهُمْ بَأْسُنَا تَضَرَّعُوا لَمَّا جَاءُهُمْ الْعَذَابُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the punishment to them. They have to humiliate themselves. They have to stop their arrogance. They have to sit in their knees. What? They did not believe in Allah. They did not humiliate themselves to Allah. They did not invoke Allah. They did not ask for forgiveness. Why? Because their hearts were hardened. And the shaitan, Satan, made what they were doing attractive to them. This is because of their hearts being hardened and the shaitan attracting them. Whatever they are doing, bad things, shaitan attracted them. That's why, dear brothers, dear sisters, please make dua for everybody. The Islamic Center of Reseda is still helping the community. Islamic Center of Reseda is still offering the service, is still offering the counseling. This is what we are doing at the Islamic Center of Reseda. That's why, dear brothers, I will give you again the phone number of the group, inshallah. We appointed them, the Brother Arif Gizallah Khair, the leader of the executive committee, Brother Arif Abidi, and our executive committee in the Islamic Center of Reseda, our community. They appointed for counseling by phone for our elders to serve them if they need food, if they need any help. to call this number 818-818. If you need any service, 818-996-996-9116. Again, 818-996-9116. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ya Rabbil Alameen, please also send your support to the Islamic Center of Rasida. Ramadan is coming, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen, later we're going to tell you. Inshallah, next week we're going to have also the same program. I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from you all. Allahumma aghfir lana wa rahamna wa taqabbal minna. Yassir lana umurana, yammin lana kitabana. Wa ahfadna min bayna adina wa min khalfina wa an aymanina wa an shabailna. Wa ja'alna laka min ash-shakirin. وصلى اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين.